Hello everyone, my name is Shihab and welcome to my channel. This is my first tutorial and if this works out, hopefully I'll make more tutorials based on DFT calculations. Building a carbon nanotube might be simple and there are already zip files available for CNT on the internet. But building a nanotube from WSE2, MOS2 or other TMD materials can be somewhat complex. In this video, I will show you how you can make monolayer TMD materials into nanotubes, which you can later use as input to quantum espresso for DFT calculations using a tool called C2X. I will use WSE2 as an example, but you can do the same for other TMD materials. Link to my GitHub repo is in the description. There you can find all the example files and detailed documentation which you can follow along. So let's get started. First, we need to download a zip file for WSE2. For that, go to materialsproject.org. We need to open a free account for downloading zip files. After opening the account, you can search for WSE2. And then you will find several zip files. We will use the one with P63MMC space group. So this is the twice edge WSE2. From file formats, we'll select a sieve and then download the zip file. Save it. After downloading it, we have to unzip it. So go to the folder, then unzip it here. Then we'll open Burai. Those of you who haven't heard of Burai, it is a UI based on Quantum Espresso, which makes using Quantum Espresso really convenient. We'll navigate to the folder where the zip file is downloaded and open it. As you can see, this is twice edge bulk WSE2. To make it into monolayer, we'll select the bottom three atoms by double clicking on them, then delete the selected atoms. After that, we'll go into modeler, then move the single layer in the middle of the init cell. For this, we'll use translation of cell and you will use C vector translation. Then we will use reflect on input file. Now we'll need to copy the contents of the input file. For this, we'll open the input file, copy the contents, then we'll from the terminal I will create a text file named wse2.in. I will paste the contents and save it. So this is a quantum espresso input file, and to use it with C2X, we will need to convert it to SIF format. For this, at first we need to open XQSDEN. Then from XQSDEN we need to open the file we just created. So open PWSCF input file, then navigate to the folder. Then just open the WSE2.in file. Press OK. So after opening it, from file menu, choose save XSF structure. Then save it in the same folder or any other folder of your choice, doesn't matter. Save it as WSE2.xsf. Now to convert it into SIF format, we will use Vesta. So open Vesta, from file menu, open, go to the folder and open the WSE2.xsf file. Here you can see the structure, and then from file menu choose export data, and remember to choose SIF format from here and bottom right corner. Then save it as wse2.cif. So finally, we have our SIF file for the monolayer. Now we'll need to convert this SIF file into .cell format. For this, we'll use a program called SIF2Cell. If you don't have it in your computer, you can use it in sudo apt-get install SIF2Cell. So we'll open a terminal in the folder, here we have our here in this folder we have a wc.cif file, and you can check my GitHub page. I have written the command which you need to put, so just copy the command and paste it on your terminal. So this will give you wc2.cell file, and then you can use this .cell file with C2X to generate a nanotube. Here I will show you how to generate a 24,0 zigzag configuration nanotube. Commands for making chiral or armchair nanotubes are given in my GitHub page. You can check them. So let me just copy the command and paste it on the terminal. So C2X has worked its magic, and this will give you a quantum espresso input file named wc2240.in, which is your desired nanotube. And we can use Burai to visualize this nanotube now. So go to Burai. We need to refresh the folder. Oh, here it is. So here is the zigzag WSC2 nanotube. You can rotate it to see better. So here is indeed the zigzag configuration, and you can try other configurations following my GitHub page. And now you can calculate the band diagram or AK diagram, DOS, or any other kind of DFT calculation you want using this quantum espresso input file. And I have some example EK diagram which I have calculated using these input files in my GitHub page. You can check them as well. So this sums up today's video. If it was helpful, don't forget to leave a like. Also consider subscribing to my channel, as I plan to make more videos like this. If you have any suggestions or face any problem with the process, please leave a comment and I will reply. Thank you.